Chichester Harbour Conservancy have got a very strong interest in the environment. We see ourselves as custodians of Chichester Harbour, and we became very concerned 2 or 3 years ago when we started learning about the prevalence of microplastics and nodules and other small bits in the harbour. In the last sort of 10 years, it's in a slow decline in the catch until this last year. The fishery authorities, Sussex IFCA, actually closed the fishery for a season.
Looking at the presence and the distribution of the microplastic, hopefully we can find the answer to the question, where does it come from? And then we can definitely move forward to think of, right, how can we stop it?
With a partnership like this, it's much easier to identify that, but then also to grow a strong response and have sufficient sort of impetus to have an impact with local politicians and even nationally if necessary. The principal activity really is to pull this symposium together.
Yeah, I think there's already a little bit of a buzz created by this symposium.
The things that stand out, I think actually the thing about glass fibres that have been embedded in plastics, the idea that the things the plastic is carrying are also then coming out of the plastic and staying in organisms, that really struck me.
Our expertise is totally different to the university's expertise, and we wouldn't have nowhere to start trying to understand what is going on here, so it's been fantastic, and their willingness to really come here and do the research and put in lots of hours at difficult times, early starts, late finishes, all kinds of weather, and their dedication has been impressive, but the combination of the two, us both helping each other out, has really given a much better result for both organisations.
We're going to look at the glass fibres, and because that is a completely novel domain and there is no research, there are no publications on that, and we really want to see where is that coming from, is it seasonal, how much harm does it do?
Very much see Chichester Harbour as a microcosm of what's going on elsewhere, and if we can identify what the issues are here, the implications here, it's got a wider resonance worldwide. I think these things will have to start locally and then build and grow.